So now that we've gone through the process of applying simple flat areas of color, I'm going to hit Command D on my Mac. That would be Control D on a PC to deselect. That frees us up to move on to the next area. And I'm going to zoom in a little bit more right here so I can look at these circles. I'm going to use those and these little forehead decorations here. So I go to my magic wand on the top layer because that's where these things are drawn. I'm going to click, shift click, shift click, shift click, shift click, shift click, and I want to select these areas as well. So I'm going to keep holding the shift key and I'm going to keep clicking all these open spaces as I hold my shift key. There we go. Now that I've selected those areas, I go to Select Menu, Modify, and Expand. I'm going to create a brand new layer for a brand new color. I'm going to pull this underneath the other layers. I'll double click on the name and let's call this Purple Decorations. Okay, I'm going to click on my foreground color. We'll select a shade of purple, kind of a lighter purple right here. I click OK. And again, on my Mac, I can hold my Option key and hit the big Delete key. On a PC, I would hold my Alt key and hit the Backspace key at the same time. Fill with the foreground color. But that looks pretty boring. It's just all flat again. So let's add some dimension to it. Command D on a Mac or Control D on a PC to deselect. And then you'll notice on my layers panel, to the far right is blank areas on each layer. If I double click that area, it brings up my layer styles, my special effects. So I can click and you'll notice you get a bunch of different effects with checkboxes. Do not click on the checkbox because nothing's going to change over here. Okay, what you do is you click on the words, bevel and emboss. Now I get to customize the look of that. So embossing kind of makes them pop out, gives it some dimension, which looks kind of cool. But I think that's a little too much. So I want the style to be, let's try an inner bevel. There we go. We got rid of all those ugly drop shadows. See, this is why you want these buttons so you can customize the effect. You only get these buttons when you click on the words. Photoshop will check the box for you. Okay, I don't like emboss. I don't like all these ugly gray shadows. So I'm going to go with an inner bevel. Keep it inside the paint. Then I want to act by smoothing it out, looking more kind of bubbly, or do I want it chiseled hard, like rubies? Then I have the depth. I can drag this back and then slowly add depth right there. I want that to come up so I can really see the difference between darks and lights. The size right here has to the left, the lower the number, the less of an edge you're going to get. To the right, you get more of an edge. You have a soften effect right there. So at zero, you get very crisp edges. As you drag that over, you get smoother edges. Do whatever you want. It's your artwork. So you get to experiment with it. So let's say I go up to there. I kind of like that look. But I'm going to click on the word contour. And then I get a little pop-up over here. These are edge contours. So notice they all have these little ramps. So when I click this one, I get a double edge right there. That looks kind of cool right there. Wasn't expecting that. Plus I get more details right here. And you could click each one and just see what they do. You get more or less parallel lines. But I really like this one right here. And I think I'm going to go with that. I'll click OK. Those are called layer styles. Okay. They're also called effects or FX. So whenever you apply those styles to a layer, you will see the FX and you'll get a little pop-up right here. I know that I did bevel and emboss, so I can close that up. I don't need to look at that anymore. And that is method number two for colorizing line art, is adding layer styles, special effects, so you can add a little bit more dimensionality to your work. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to apply filters, Photoshop filters, for some really cool textured effects.